Hello, my name is John Stamos. This is the second part of our tutorial on the basic setup for a character for importing into Max. We're going to be skinning and rigging and animating a character. For this, you're going to need the UDK December 2010 beta. Also, you'll need 3ds Max 2011. The date is January 24th, 2011. Okay, so where we last left off, we had created a basic biped. And here we now have that biped with our skeletal mesh brought in, and we have gone in and tweaked our biped to fit within the skeletal mesh. Now, to do that, there's a couple things you need to do. First of all, I have frozen my skeletal mesh so that all I really am going to be messing with at this point in time is the biped. To actually manipulate and move your biped around to get it to where you need it to go, you need to come over to the motion tab, which is this sort of vibrating circle right here. And you need to turn on figure mode, which is this stick man right here. And once you do that, you can actually then come in and you can select a specific part and you can move it around and move it to fit wherever you need to. So if I want to get into this arm, I can move it just with the basic move tool. I can select the hand and get that in a better rotation if I want to. You can rotate it, and you can even resize it to make it a little bigger. So these are things that you can do to make sure things are fitting properly. And then once you have it in the place that you need it to go, this is when you're going to want to first of all turn off your figure mode, and I'm going to unfreeze all at this point in time so that I can have my skeletal mesh selected. So, and also an important thing to note is pretty much these are the only two things you want to have in your scene at this point. You don't want to have a bunch of other objects laying around, and the reason for that I will show you right now. So I have my skeletal mesh selected, and I'm going to want to attach my biped to the mesh. So I go into, I have him selected, I go into the create tab, or not the create tab, sorry, the modify tab, and I'm going to click on skin, and that's going to give me this drop down here, these parameters. Once I have that, I'm going to click edit envelope, and I'm going to come down here to this area that says bones, add, and then there's this blank screen beneath it. I'm going to click on add, and it's going to pop up this window, which is going to show me all the possible bones in the scene that I can use to attach and weigh to my skeletal mesh. So this is pretty simple. There's just a couple things you need to keep in mind. Basically, I want to select all of these except for anything that has nub at the end of it. Those are that green box you see right there, and there's a couple of the hands and there's some of the feet. Those are not what you want to select. Those are basically that's information gathered for where things kind of meet up and how they move. So that's not the actual bone. So you want to go in and you actually want to deselect anything with nub in the title. Just make sure we get it all. And that looks like everything. So I'm going to select those. And with that, everything should be weighted. So I should be able to select this, and now, as you can see, I can move my character around. And you can see there's some weird stuff going on there, like, you know, the skeletal mesh isn't moving properly with that. That's the next stage of kind of tweaking that we'll be dealing with in the next tutorial for when we get started actually animating our rig. So, but that is basically how you skin a character. And so for the next tutorial, we will go into tweaking it so that it works properly for animation.